So have you ever seen a situation where some individuals in a family are left to fight over the estate of a loved one who has passed? Unfortunately, I have seen that, and it is something that can get really ugly really quick. People start to position themselves so that they can move in and pounce to get the things that they believe is theirs, that they have rights to or that they should have over another. And people begin to burn bridges. They actually begin to separate themselves from family over temporary things. They want what they feel they deserve, their inheritance.
Hi, I'm Pete, and this is my wife, Shauna, and we are ordained ministers in the Church of God. And every day we come into your home through social media asking you to partake in Bible study with us. This is the way we disciple our family, and we hope that you do so as well and choose to study the Word of God on a daily basis. And I hope we do it with us. Today's scripture is Romans 8, 14 through 17. I'm going to read that and we'll get started. For those who are led by the Spirit of God are children of God. The Spirit you receive does not make you slaves so that you live in fear again. Rather, the Spirit you receive brought about your adoption to sonship. And by him we cry, Abba, Father. The Spirit himself testifies with our spirit that we are God's children. Now, if we be the children of God, then we are heirs, heirs of God and co-heirs with Christ. If indeed we share in the sufferings in order that we may also be in his glory.
Now, the spiritual world, it does not work like the scenario that I talked about in the beginning. Because the Apostle Paul is explaining to us here in these verses that God the Father does not have limited resource. There wasn't one diamond ring. There wasn't
one crown.
Yeah, there wasn't one crown. There wasn't one thing for us to all fight over. But he is a God that has no limits.
Right, and he talks about, you know, whenever we are led by the Spirit of God, remember we've been talking about the flesh and the spirit battling. When we let the Spirit reign, then we become children of God. Mm-hmm. Right, he says that we are adopted in and we become joint heirs with Christ. So we are entitled to everything. We don't have to split it. We don't have to argue it. We don't have to say, Daddy would have wanted me to have that, or Mama said that
she
I could have this.
She told me one time, I remember, yeah. It was on a Tuesday on a cold November day.
Yeah, that ring was mine.
Yeah.
No, that's not how it works in the kingdom of God, right? We get it all. There is no limitations, right? We all get the eternal life. We all get to spend eternity in his presence. And we have to realize that is a wonderful reward. And it's a great thing to know that he is willing to accept us and bring us into his family.
You know, God does the amazing, and he absolutely blows our mind. And he opens his arms up and his home up and his family up and his blessings up and all his power up and all those things, and he says, it's yours. He says, if you are my child, then you have every right to the peace, to right. The love, to the joy, to the power, to the gifts of the Spirit, to all those things, to eternal life and your time in glory.
You know, you think about it, we've talked about through the book of Romans that we are all rebellious. We've all sinned, that Jesus died for us, even though we were evil and reprobate. And you think about that, wouldn't it be an awesome thing for him just to be like, all right, I'm not going to put you to death. I'm just going to let you be the janitor in the house for the rest of your life. That would be great, right? I'm not going to die. Or, hey, you're going to be the gardener. You're going to do that. You're going to work your fields, or you're going to mine coal for me for the rest of your life. But you're not going to be in punishment. You're not going to be in hell. That would be great, right? But no, that's not what he does. He says, not only are you not going to go to hell, but you get all of it.
Right.
You're in. Right? There's no, you got to pay me back. You go right to joint heir with Jesus Christ.
Yeah.
You're going to inherit my kingdom. You're going to rule and reign with Christ whenever he comes back for his millennial reign here upon the earth. And you think about that, that is unthought of. You know, it'd be nice for us to show mercy to someone and say, all right, you don't have to pay me back the $1 million you owe me. Right? Okay, that's fine. It's forgiven. But what if you said, you know what, you not only do you not have to pay me back $1 million, but here's my check card. You can have it all. That's what God did.
Mm-hmm.
He hands the keys over to us. He gives us the ATM number or whatever you want to call it. And he says, here, it's yours. It's all yours. The inheritance is yours.
It's amazing to think, you know, that God may look at it this way, that, you know what? I don't need all this stuff. I have you. It was you that I wanted. It was the fellowship with you. It was the relationship with you that I wanted. So I'm going to give you everything that I have. All that I have is yours now, because what I really wanted was you.
Right. You know, we all deserve the death penalty, right? But God makes a way that we can share in His glory. And I thank Him for that. Me and Shauna are truly, truly thankful that He did that for us, because both of us know where we were heading if He didn't.
That's right.
So going forward this week, study Romans chapter 8. Talk about it, discuss it with your family, with your friends, around the dinner table, in the car. Great scriptures here. A lot of good edifying scripture. Studied on a daily basis. And remember, there's four things that a disciple does every day of their life.
That is, you're going to take time to encounter God. Be with Him in His presence. Exalt Him. That's a great way to get into His presence. Edify yourself with the reading of the Word. Know what God says about you and about your life.
Mm-hmm.
And you're going to engage this world for Christ. Share what you've learned. Share what God's done for you, and let others know that Jesus died for them because He loved them so very much. Until next time, may God bless you.